This journey is known as enlightenment. Enlightenment is another word so much misunderstood. People think it's something supernatural where light starts coming out of the head and blue lights is coming out of there, here and there. So many different versions of what people think what enlightenment is, that people start knowing everything when they get enlightened. Very simple meaning to enlightenment, which is that your inner guru is awakened. Your consciousness is awakened, which becomes your guide in everything that you do. In everything that you do, in every aspect of your life, you have the body to consult. You have the mind to tell you its own rationals. You have the spirit to also tell you deeper urges, deeper desires of you. But you have a consciousness that decides, that guides, that shows you where to go and where not to go. This journey is not a one session thing. This journey is not covered in 10 minutes of meditation or 5 minutes of meditation or 5 steps to enlightenment. This journey takes time. This journey is when you constantly move inwards, reflect, and brighten this consciousness in you, this inner guide in you, and uplift this to a point where it's above your body, above your mind, above your spirit. In this session, we are going to take 4 steps, 4 simple steps, and then you can continue, if you like, in your own life, this journey in whichever ways you like. The first step in today's session, you will listen to your body. You will see how your body is your inner guide. What is your body guiding you towards? You'll sit down silently, not having to do anything, but just listening to your body, being aware of your body. Listen. Maybe, first of all, it tells you the obvious, which is, my legs are hurting, my head is hurting, I have pain here, or I cannot sit like this. How long do I need to sit like this? This would be the obvious, what your body will tell you. But if you listen longer, maybe there is something more that your body has to say. All you have to do is listen. Remain silent. Don't get involved. Just listen to your body. Let the body be your guru, be your guide, and tell you what it wants to tell you. Then we'll move on to your mind, where you bring your awareness to your mind, to your thoughts, and again observe your mind. Listen to your mind very silently. You don't participate in that conversation. You don't participate in that thoughts, in those thoughts, and take them somewhere. You stay silent. Just observe, listen to your inner conversation, to your thoughts, and see if they are just repeating and creating a past or something more. Or is mind having to say something more? Can mind guide you to something new? See for yourself. Then you will bring your awareness to your heart, which is to represent your spirit. And you'll just feel a non-verbal communication coming out of your heart, and just be aware of what your heart is saying, what your spirit is saying. If you prefer, you can listen to your gut or your heart, wherever, bring your awareness to that area. And just listen, observe, watch, see what it is trying to tell you, and remain aware of it. Once you're finished with your body, once you're finished with your mind, once you're finished with listening to your spirit, is the time to awaken your awareness, awaken your consciousness. For that, you will bring your awareness to the third eye center. This is the center in the chakra philosophy as your center of awareness, and you'll keep your awareness at this Agya chakra, Ajna chakra, third eye center, in the middle of your eyebrows for a few more minutes, and let all your awareness center here, not thinking about the body anymore, not thinking about the mind anymore, not thinking about the spirit anymore, and just remain aware of your third eye center here. And once you're done with that as well, you'll sit in silence without doing anything and enjoy the energy, enjoy the peace, enjoy the inner stillness that arises out of this process, the consciousness that arises out of this process.